Hi everyone, my name is Thomas Kim. Today is September 30th, 2020. This is my 68th episode about vector calculus and classical electromagnetism. In this episode, I will discuss numerical double integrals of general region in C++. More specifically, Fubini's theorem, stronger form. I will solve example 2 and example 3 in chapter 15.2, page 841, Thomas's Calculus 12th edition. If you do not have this book, you can double click this link and download Thomas's Calculus 12th edition. This is Thomas's Calculus 12th edition, chapter 15, section 2, double integrals of general region. Scroll down. We will implement Fubini's theorem stronger form. Now here, the range of x, is a, b constant. The range of y, is now function g1x, g2x. In this case, the range of y, is CD constant. The range of X is H1Y, H2Y, H1Y, H2Y functions. We will implement Fubini's theorem, the stronger form, in this episode. Please understand that my current session continues from my previous episode, episode 67. Please double-click this link. If you haven't watched episode 67, Numerical Multiple Integrals in C++, Double Integrals, Fubini's Theorem, First Form, please watch it. Otherwise, you may not understand my current and future sessions. Scroll down, show more, scroll down. In the download source code section, please double-click this link. Keep. Show in folder. Unzip it. Right click. Rename. 068 Fubini stronger form. Copy. Paste it in your working folder. Start Visual Studio Code. Open the working folder. In the folder 68, double click partial, Ctrl V. We will solve example 2 in page 844. I will arrange side by side like this. This is page 845, example 2. We will calculate this double integral. Control and here, void test Fubini stronger form, example 2 dx dy. Copy this function name, copy, paste it here. Disable it. Now we are solving this example first. Dx dy, dx dy. Oro f equals oro x oro y. Don't forget semicolon here. Return std sine x over x. We defined this integrand sine x of x. Now oro y is lower bound of x, 1 is upper bound of x. X1 lower bound of x. This is lambda oro y return y. lower bound of x is a function of y, or x2 is 1, so 1.0. Upper bound of x is constant double 1.0. Now we define Toplafon function xy f xy this function f copy faced or dx dy equals we now compute this integral like this f xy we integrate dx dy integrate xy. The first argument is x1, x2, y1, y2. So x1, x2, y1, y1 is lower bound over y is 0, 0, upper bound over y is 1. Now string dx dy equals dx dy and there. We have to be careful two things in this function. First off, function xy can take lambda that takes two arguments. We should create a lambda that takes two parameters, x and y, two parameters. Don't forget this. Secondly, the type of x1 is a lambda closure. The type of x2 is type double. So the type of x1, the type of x2 are different. Now scroll down. Void test Puvini stronger form example 2 dy dx. Copy the function name, copy, paste it here. This is dx dy, this is dy dx. They are different. Here I will change example 2. Now we are implementing this part. This is the same. Copy, paste, sine x over x, sine x over x is the same. Now we are defining this is y, y1, y2, lower bound of y, upper bound of y, like this. Or y1 equals 0.0, lower bound of y. Or y2 should be the function of x. Or x, don't forget, semicolon, returns x, upper bound of y. Now, talk, play, fun, function xy, fxy, we provide this function. Now we integrate or dy, we integrate dy first, then dx, dx equal fxy integrate yx. The first is y1, y2. Now, 0 is lower bound of x, 1 is upper bound of x. 0, 1. String, example 2, dy, dx. Dy, dx, and there. This function evaluates this integral. This function evaluates this integral, the result is the same, but the bound of dx dy, the bound of dx dy are different. Now scroll down. This is example 3. Here, void test Fubini stronger form example 3. We will compute dy dx first. Dy dx. Copy this function name first. Here, auto f equals auto x auto y. Don't forget semicolon. Return 4.0 times x plus 2.0. We defined this integrand 4.0 times x plus 2. Now, the range of y, this is y1, this is y2. Auto y1 equals auto x return x times x. Lower bound of y, auto y2, auto x return 2x. 2.0 times x, upper bound of y. Now, talk play fun, function xy, fxy, we pass this lambda closure here. Now, auto dy dx equal fxy, we integrate dy first, integrate yx, y1, y2, lower bound of x is 0, 2, 0, 2, screen, example, this is example 3, dy, dx, dy, dx, and then this should be example 3. I will copy this function, copy, paste it here. This is typo. Now scroll up. We will implement this part. Void test Fubini stronger form example 3 dx dy. The integrand is the same. So I will copy and paste it here. Now dx lower bound of x is y over 2, upper bound of x is square root y. Auto x1 equals auto y, don't forget semicolon here, return y over 2.0, lower bound of x, auto x2, auto y, return std square root y, upper bound of x. Now, talk play fun, function xy, fxy, this is f. Auto, we are integrating dx dy. Dx dy equals fxy. Integrate dx dy, x1, x2. The range of y, 0, 4, 0, 4. Stream, example 3. Dx dy, dx dy, and there. Now copy this function, copy, paste it here. Please note that up to this point, we defined problems, But we haven't implemented our algorithm yet. Example 2 dxdy. Example 2 dxdy. Lower bound, upper bound of x is a function. In the example 2 dydx, dydx, lower bound, upper bound of y is a function of x. We have to implement our algorithm. We will start integrate dx dy. I will make it bigger. Here, template, type name, PALAM, type 1, type name, PALAM, type 2. We introduced template type parameter, copy, paste, forwarding reference, copy, paste, forwarding reference. I will copy this, paste it here, parameter type, like this, parameter type 2, like this. It should be forwarding reference. Integrate xy calls integrate x, integrate yx calls integrate y. Now, parameter y1, parameter y2 in integrate y, these are now can be lambda. y1, y2 can be lambda. Also, integrate xy calls integrate x, x1, x2, x1, x2 can be lambda. So, we have to update integrate x, integrate y. Currently, value type is not lambda. Now, control home. Here, I define concept like this. Template type name, func type, type name, arg type, concept, parameter, c requires, func type, f, arg type, a. We are using compound requirements, std, convertible to arg type. Here, we are calling f a. We constrain f is a callable with argument a and returns a type convertible to arg type. Now, I will maximize it. Scroll down, integrate x, copy, paste. We now introduce template. Template, parameter, c, value type, PALAM, type 1, parameter, c, value type, PALAM, type 2. Copy, paste, forwarding reference, copy, paste, forwarding reference. Now change it to L value reference, L value reference. Arguments x1 and x2 are callables with y as arguments. So x1 and y1 are callables with arguments y, y, y. Now copy this once again. Paste. Argument x1 is callable with y as argument. Fix your code like this. Fix value type. remove ampersand here. Here, Y1 is callable. Y2 is not. Now copy once again. Copy, paste, argument X2 is callable with Y as argument. Now, value type X1, copy parameter type, forwarding reference, remove ampersand here, put ampersand. X1 is not callable, but X2 is callable with Y. So, we added one value lambda, lambda, value, lambda, lambda. In the same manner, integrate Y, copy, paste, template, parameter, C, value type, parameter, type 1, parameter, C, value type, parameter, type 2. Copy, paste, forwarding reference, copy, paste, forwarding reference. It should be L value reference, L value reference. Now, X1, X2 are callable X as argument. X as argument. Arguments Y1 and Y2 are callable with X as argument. Now, copy this. Paste argument Y1 is callable with X as argument. Fix like this. Fix value type. Now remove ampersand here. Y2 is not callable. Copy. Paste. Argument Y2 is callable value type PALAM type forwarding reference. Now remove ampersand here, put ampersand here. Y1 is not callable, Y2 is callable. Now scroll up from here. I will fix some wording. Arguments X1, X2 are callable with Y as argument. Scroll down. Argument X1 is callable with Y as argument. Argument X2 is not callable. Scroll down. Argument X2 is callable with Y as argument. Argument X1 is not callable. Scroll down. Arguments Y1 and Y2 are not callable. Scroll down. Scroll down. Argument Y1 is callable with X as argument. Argument Y2 is not callable. Argument Y2 is callable. Argument Y1 is not callable. There is some simpler and easier way than these overloadings. Both Microsoft compiler and GNU G++ compiler support this simpler and easier way, but Clang compiler does not support the simpler and easier way. So I had to overload lots of functions for compatibility with Clang compiler. Now start command prompt. DIR CD 068 FUBINI stronger POM clang plus plus SCD C plus plus 20 partial dot CPP LTBB OC.exe hit enter. Wow, it built CLS C. Now let's compare the result. I will make it smaller. Scroll down. Example 2 DXDY. This is example 2 DXDY. The result is 0.46. DXDY 0.459. DYDX 0.459. This is approximate value, so our result is correct. In case of example 3, scroll down. This is example 3. DYDX, DYDX. The correct answer is 8. DXDY, the correct answer is 8. Now we can increase the precision. Show vector.cpp. Control end. Let's increase the step to 7. We build again. CLS C. The computational result DXDY is now improved. This integration by increasing the count of ways in this function, we can improve the precision. Please note that these are exact correct solution of our problem.